Hey guys, Two Roads here. I just want to give you a bit of an introduction to printing and painting the Tracer Chronal Accelerator that I put together. And that's this model here. I've printed and painted up the model that has the dome in the center. There's also the version that does not have the dome in the center. If you want to do something like LEDs, or if you're looking for something that's not as, let's say, exciting, a little more kind of offline tracer, if you will. So in printing this model, what I did is my first attempt, I actually tried it at a 0.35 layer height. It took about 4 hours, but there was a lot of layer lines on this dome in particular that I wasn't really fond of. I didn't want to take the time to fill it in and sand it. I'm a little lazy, sorry. So I went back and I used the variable layer height in my slicer that I use. So most of this is printed at a 0.2 height. And then I went back and I added a little bit of 0.1 right at the top of this dome to give a little bit of less of those layer lines. If you look really closely, although it's probably easier to see in the pictures with the model, you will see some layer lines where I printed, but if you take a step back, it really doesn't show that much. So it's not a huge deal. So this piece comes with a main chest piece. It's gonna come with two bolts and then this bottom handle piece. For me, when I painted this, they actually stuck in there pretty well, but I am gonna take them back out and do a little bit of glue in there, but it does swing pretty freely, so that's a nice little feature. So in addition to this main chest piece, you're gonna see a couple of rings that you're gonna be able to print out. One note on the rings is that this top part, you'll see there's a top and kind of two side pieces. The top is really meant to align with the top of the model. I've given you kind of these little ridges, if you will, and they're designed to be stuck on those, because you'll notice this isn't really a circle. It's, you know, got all these angles and sides on it. So that's meant to go that way. I'll probably end up using just this outer ring. There's also the inner ring, which is a little bit smaller. Same concept, just goes on the inner part here. Same thing, top goes up. But for me, once I had both of these rings on there, I felt like it covered up a little bit too much of the bronze. It covered up a little bit too much of this central layer here. And I really want people to see this main part and not so much the rings. Another feature of this that doesn't make it so much of a on-the-shelf model, but more of a cosplay model, is there are four openings. There's two at the top and then two down towards the bottom. And those are meant to hold your straps. So you're gonna be able to feed a strap through, you're gonna have two that are gonna come up the shoulder, and then two that are gonna go under the chest in order to attach it to the rest of your tracer costume. So hopefully I'm gonna work on doing a back part to this, and then eventually the other armor pieces as well that go with it, but for right now this is what I've got, so there you go. A note on painting this: when I first primed it, I thought, oh hey, here's this hammered silver primer. It was a little bit of a disaster. It was sticky. I did it on a little bit of a humid day, but shouldn't have been that bad. I would really not suggest doing this. I would do a flat primer. I've got this 2X ultra coverage that actually worked pretty well. It didn't run a terrible amount and was a lot better for being able to print things up and get them painted. So this has kind of been painted over entirely. I don't know that I have a lot of that hammered silver left on it. So if you have any questions, just give me a shout in the comments and I'll be happy to answer them.